There was a stage when, I mean, during the first, just at the beginning of the war, we were in England, and then when the war started, we were sort of stuck here. My father had to go back. And then later on, we followed, and we went through France just before the collapse of France, and we went to the Lebanon, and that stage put into a school in the Lebanon, because it was sort of still during the school term, and I had to go to a school which was a quite different kind of school, French-type school, totally different kind of education. I survived only there for a term. I wouldn't have liked to have stayed there much longer. So my schooling wasn't that disturbed by the travelling around. That was the only time when I had a bit of, you know, strange surroundings. But the travelling, I think, as children, you enjoy it. When we did the journey back from Khartoum to Cairo, on our own, my brother was 2 years younger, I was 12, he was 10, we would do this four-day journey, involving one day on the train, 2 days on the Nile steamer, another day on the train, well, no, all on our own, with a few people helping us when we got to the station. And I think it probably develops a bit of independence and resilience. If you get used to that sort of thing, you're not so dependent on people chaperoning you around. So I think it's probably helpful. Mm. My father's position was he was the Sudan government, and he was he took over the job, in fact, from his uncle before him. And the job really was more or less kind of liaison between the British government and the Sudanese, because my father went to Oxford and English educated, and so he could put the British point of view to the Sudanese, and he knew the Sudanese. So he was kind of go-between between in the political service between the Sudan government and the Sudanese. And then during the war, he got involved with the broadcasting, Sudanese radio and that side of it. So it was an interesting job, because, and then he led right up to the sort of when Sudan became independent at the end of the war, and it's launching that movement. And then after the war, when he came to this country, he was more freelance, and he wrote a lot of books, and also did a lot of broadcasting for the BBC taking part in and writing for the media, political on general political questions to do with the Middle East. So he was of civil service, moving into the political area and enjoying himself writing books on the side. So it's quite a varied sort of background, but yeah. Very much a non-mathematical one. He studied history,
yeah.
And nobody else in the immediate family was at all mathematical. Mm. So, it meant that I had a kind of cultured background, lots of books around the house, and yeah. I was introduced to sort of literature and music and art things in a way that perhaps my own children perhaps didn't get some exposure to.